Hello friends and welcome to Pendulum Medium. Today we'll be discussing daily current affairs of 4th July 2020. So guys, quickly join the session and also ask other people to join this session. And those who have not subscribed to our channel Pendulum Medium, please subscribe it and do not forget to press the bell icon to receive notification. Let's see what are the news of today. First news is the Defence Procurement Council approved the purchase of defence equipment worth ₹38,900 crore, which is required for the Indian military forces. And this decision was taken by the Defence Procurement Council meeting. And this Defence Procurement Council, first of all, the Defence Procurement Council, it is a highest decision-making body. Which formulates the or finalize the policies related to the three services, that is Indian Army, Indian Navy and Indian Air Force, and also Indian Coast Guard. And this Defence Procurement Council, it was formed in 2001, and it is chaired by Defence Minister of India. Okay, so who is the current defense minister? Mr. Rajnath Singh. So he is currently chaired the Defense Procurement Council, and this Defense Procurement Council was formed in 2001. And this Defense Procurement Council meeting, it emphasized on indigenously designing and developing products in the country and promoting the concept of self-reliant or Atma Nirbhar. And in under this deal, there were mainly four equipments, that is 21 MiG fighter jets they will be brought, and 59 existing jets they will be upgraded. So first is a MiG-29 fighter jets, and secondly HAL, the Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, it will build 12 Sukhoi 30 MKI aircrafts. And also this deal include Pinaka. Pinaka is an indigenously developed all-weather indirect fire and free flight artillery rocket system. Pinaka rocket system is also included in the deal. And this Pinaka system, it has the capacity to neutralize variety of targets such as exposed enemy troops, armored and soft skin vehicles, communication centers, air terminal complexes, fuel and ammunition dumps. So it can neutralize such variety of targets. This Pinaka, which is an indigenously developed all-weather indirect fire free flight artillery rocket system. And also this deal include a long-range land attack missile of over 1000 km range and Astra. Astra is, as from the name you can imagine, that it is air-to-air missile. So many a times the questions are asked in the form like a particular missile is given and they ask that whether it is an air-to-air missile, air-to-surface missile, surface-to-surface missile. So this Astra missile is air-to-air missile. Okay, and this Astra, it is also part of the deal along with long-range land attack missile system of over 1000 km range. And this Astra air-to-air missile, it has been designed and developed by DRDO. So this is important because question can also be asked that which of the following missile is designed and developed by DRDO. Okay, so Astra is one of them. Now moving to the question part. Recently, Defence Acquisition Council approved the purchase of defence equipment worth ₹38,900 crore, which of the following is included in the deal. So quickly comment the correct answer: MiG-29 fighter jets, Sukhoi 30 MKI aircraft, Pinaka rocket system and all of the above. What will be the correct answer? Quickly comment. The correct answer will be option D, that is all of the above. These are included in the recent deal, which has been decided by Defence Acquisition Council. It has given the approval for the purchase of these defence equipments. Moving to the next news, drug discovery hackathon. It has been recently launched, and this hackathon has been jointly launched by Human Resource Development Minister Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank and Health Minister Dr. Harshvardhan. This will be an online competition and it is a national initiative to aid drug discovery process, and this competition, it offers opportunities for professionals, researchers, students all over the world to attract international talent. And also the Human Resource Development Innovation Cell, HRD Innovation Cell, and AICTE, they'll focus on identifying potential drug molecules through this hackathon. And these potential drug molecules, they'll be sent for synthesis and laboratory testing by the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, that is CSIR. So this CSIR, it has been in news from a long time, because many laboratories of CSIR, they have been undergoing various researches for COVID-19. So quickly comment, where is the headquarters of CSIR located? Quickly comment, very easy answer. Yes, headquarters of CSIR located in New Delhi. Moving to the question part, Drug Discovery Hackathon 2020, it has been launched by which ministry? Quickly comment the correct answer. Ministry of Human Resource Development, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Ministry of Home Affairs, both A and B. The correct answer will be option D, that is both A and B, Ministry of Human Resource Development and Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. They jointly launched this Drug Discovery Hackathon 2020. Moving to the next news, Russian President Vladimir Putin will remain President of Russia until 2036. So recently a referendum was held in the country, and the Russian President Vladimir Putin, he has the citizens have voted in favor of him in this referendum, which was held last week, and now he has been allowed to serve as the president for the next two terms, of each of which is of 6 years. So basically, if we talk about Russia, so there is semi-presidential system. Semi-presidential system means that there is a president along with a prime minister. Who is the current prime minister of Russia? Quickly comment. Mikhail Mishustin. He is the current prime minister of Russia. So in a semi-presidential system, there is president and there is prime minister. Prime minister is the head of government, president is the head of the state, but president is elected directly by the people, and prime minister is responsible to the legislature. And in this system, more powers are vested in the hands of president. And now, initially, the constitution of Russia, it says that any president will be eligible, will be able to up, or you can say an individual will be able to serve as president only for two terms. And now, the constitution, for the constitutional amendment, this referendum was held in Russia, in which 76.24 of the citizens voted in favor of Mr. Putin, and the constitutional amendment has been now taken place, under which the term for the president has been extended for next two terms of 6 years each. So the current term has to be ended on 2024, and after this 6 years for first term and then next 6 years for the second term. So Mr. Putin will be serving as the president of Russia till 2036, that is for next two terms, which is of each 6 years. So this is all about Russian polity. Like, there is a semi-presidential system, and if we compare with India, so in India there is a parliamentary form of government, in which there is president and prime minister. Prime minister is the head of the government, president is the head of the state, but president is indirectly elected by the people, and more powers are vested in the hands of prime minister and the council of ministers. But all the necessary decisions, the major decisions, are taken under the name of president in the parliamentary form of government. Now moving to the question part, But before that, let's know something about Russia. Russia, it is an intercontinental country which is located in Eastern Europe and North Asia. So you can see the location of Russia. It covers the largest area in the world. It covers around 17 million square kilometers. So basically, it is the largest country in the world in terms of area. And you can see the boundary of Russia. This is the region it covers. And this is the capital of this Russia is Moscow, and the currency is Russian ruble. Now moving to the question part. Under the referendum held in Russia, Vladimir Putin has received permission to serve as Russian president until which year? Quickly comment the correct answer. 2024, 2030, 2036 and 2025. This is a very important news. The correct answer will be option C, that is 2036. Whenever you are studying any constitution of any country, then compare it with Indian constitution, because the questions can be asked related to that. Now moving to the next news. Tamil Nadu government announced a monthly stipend of rupees 3000 for junior lawyers for 2 years, and this stipend has been announced to help junior lawyers to overcome their financial difficulties during this COVID-19. And as we all know that for a junior lawyer to become an independent, to practice as an independent lawyer, it takes at least 3 to 4 years, and during that time, if they'll get monthly stipend, then it will help them overcome their financial difficulties. And the Bar Council of Tamil Nadu, they had been demanding stipend for a long time. And before this also, for over three decades, the Tamil Nadu government has been implementing an advocate welfare scheme, under which on the death of the advocate, 7 lakh rupees are being given to their families. So, and now along with this advocate welfare scheme, the government will be providing the monthly stipend of rupees 3000 for the next 2 years to the young advocates, or you can say junior lawyers. Now tell me quickly that who is the current chief minister of Tamil Nadu? Comment quickly. E.K. Palani Swami. He is the current chief minister of Tamil Nadu. Governor is Banwari Lal Purohit. The capital of Tamil Nadu is Chennai. Very easy. Lok Sabha seats. There are 39 Lok Sabha seats for Tamil Nadu, and Rajya Sabha seats are 18. Okay. Moving to the question part. Recently, Tamil Nadu government has announced a monthly stipend of rupees dash for junior lawyers for 2 years. Quickly comment the correct answer. 5000, 2000, 3000 and 4000. Guys, keep commenting the correct answer and also hit the like button. Also ask your friends to join this session. Try to add more and more people to this session. Yes, option C will be the correct answer. Moving to the next news. World famous Sharavani Mela postponed in Deogarh, Jharkhand due to COVID-19 pandemic. And as we all know that due to COVID-19 pandemic, many major festivals or fairs or cultural events, they have been either postponed or they have been conducted with utmost care due to this COVID-19 pandemic. And the decision has been taken to postpone this Mela, this Shravani Mela, which is held every year in Deogarh, Jharkhand. So due to the COVID-19, because the government is unable to make the preparations for the people during this COVID-19 pandemic. But Goda MP Nishikant Dubey, he has challenged the decision of the government in the Jharkhand High Court. And one more news related to this was that the Jagannath Rath Yatra, which is held every year in Puri, Odisha. So a decision was taken by the Supreme Court to conduct the Rath Yatra, but that has to be conducted with utmost care, and only the temple personals will be participating in that event. So the event was organized with very less number of people so that the social distancing could be maintained and there are less chances of transmission of the disease. Talking about Deogarh, it is a holy city on the banks of Mayurakshi River in the eastern Indian state of Jharkhand. So basically Deogarh, it is a city in Jharkhand which is situated on the banks of Mayurakshi River. So a place which is in news, now Deogarh is in news. So there may be a question that Deogarh is located on which river, on the banks of which river? So it is located on the banks of Mayurakshi River. And the ancient Baba Badrinath temple complex, it is also located in Deogarh. It is an important Hindu pilgrimage site and many devotees, they come in the month of Sawan to visit the temple. Talking about Jharkhand, it is an eastern state of India. It was carved out of Bihar on 15 November 2000. Its capital is Ranchi. The current governor is Draupadi Murmu and the chief minister is Hemant Soren. Now quickly comment, how many Lok Sabha seats are there in Jharkhand? Quickly comment the correct answer. Lok Sabha seats in Jharkhand. There are 14 seats and in Rajya Sabha, there are 6 seats for Jharkhand. Okay. Now, moving to the question part. In which state is the ancient Baba Badrinath temple located? Quickly comment the correct answer. Such type of questions are asked in art and culture section of general awareness. Bihar, Jharkhand, Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. Quickly comment the correct answer. The temples, festivals, whichever they are in use. So automatically becomes important from the general awareness point of view. The correct answer will be option B, that is Jharkhand. Now moving to the next news. Inauguration of country's first plasma bank in New Delhi. Recently, the chief minister of New Delhi, that is Arvind Kejriwal, he inaugurated the country's first plasma bank in New Delhi. And this facility, it has been set up at the Institute of Liver and Biliary Sciences, New Delhi. This plasma bank, it will remove barriers to patients receiving plasma therapy. And the chief minister of New Delhi, he has urged people to come and donate their plasma. And only those who are previously infected with coronavirus and now they have recovered from it, they can donate this plasma. So what is this plasma therapy? This plasma therapy, in this, what happens that the plasma from the blood of recovered COVID-19 patient is transfused to a critically ill coronavirus patient. Suppose this is patient 1 and this is patient 2. This patient 1, he has recovered from COVID-19. So the plasma of this patient 1 will be used to transfuse in the blood of patient 2, who is critically ill, suffering from COVID-19. So this plasma of the recovered patient will be infused in the blood of the patient 2, and this will help, since this patient 1, their antibodies have been developed to fight with this COVID-19. So the same antibodies, they will be transferred through this plasma in the patient 2, and this patient 2, he'll be now able to fight the infection due to the presence of these antibodies. So this is basically the concept of plasma therapy. And Delhi is one of the first few states approved by ICMR to test plasma treatment for COVID-19, which is still in the testing phase. So this plasma therapy, this is not new. It has been used previously for the treatment of various other diseases, like in case of Ebola virus, it was used when the outbreak of Ebola virus occurred, and also it was used for H1N1 influenza virus. This technique, this therapy has also been used for HIV. So these are some of the diseases for which this plasma therapy has been used. So this plasma therapy is not new technique, but this is the previous technique which can be helpful in fighting this COVID-19. Now let's see a question related to the news. Where is the country's first plasma bank inaugurated? Chennai, Patna, Varanasi and New Delhi. Quickly comment the correct answer. It's very easy. Where is the country's first plasma bank inaugurated? And this is very important question because I hope this will be asked definitely in any of the exam that will be conducted soon. The correct answer will be option D, that is New Delhi. Moving to the next news, IIT Kanpur developed classroom to home learning setup Mobile Masterji. And this setup, it can record lectures or instructions by teachers using smartphones. And as we all know that due to COVID-19, the classroom teaching system, it has come to a standstill. And the students in the rural areas, they have been affected mostly by this. And this class to home learning setup, it will help solve this problem which is being faced by the students of rural India and also the teachers. This product is very lightweight and it has adjustments to fit sheets and book on it for delivering instructions to the kids. This Mobile Masterji, it can hold position and focus the whole recording setup while making the online class for a comfortable home environment. So this is a good initiative by IIT Kanpur. Now let's see a question related to the news. Which institute has developed class to home learning setup Mobile Masterji? IIT Kanpur, IIT Madras, IIT Mumbai and IIT Guwahati. Quickly comment the correct answer. Which institute has developed this classroom to home learning setup Mobile Masterji? The correct answer will be option A, that is IIT Kanpur. Moving to the next news, eminent Bollywood choreographer Saroj Khan died due to cardiac arrest. She was 71 years old and in the career of her over 4 decades, she choreographed over 2000 songs. She learned dance while working under the film choreographer B. Sohan Lal, and she was awarded the National Award thrice for her contribution for choreographing the very famous songs like Hawa Hawaii, very famous song of Shri Devi, you all know this Hawa Hawaii, then Ek Do Teen performed by Madhuri Dixit. These were some of the songs, very famous songs for which she was awarded the National Award. And she was one of the most successful choreographer of Bollywood. Now moving to the question part. Recently, Saroj Khan died due to a cardiac arrest. She was a successful dash choreographer, painter, writer and scientist. Quickly comment the correct answer. Yes, option A is the correct answer. Now moving to the next news, Lepidopterist discovered 2 new species of butterflies in Arunachal Pradesh. So first of all, this Lepidopterist, these are the scientists or people who study butterflies or moths. So Lepidopterist are the people who study butterflies or moths. So they have discovered 2 new species of butterflies in Arunachal Pradesh. The names of these species are striped hairstreak and elusive prince. This striped hairstreak, as you can see in the image, was first recorded by Japanese entomologist. These entomologists are the people who study insects. So a Japanese entomologist, they recorded this striped hairstreak in Hainan province of China. The elusive prince, this belongs to Vietnam. You can see this is the elusive prince, and it is believed to belong to the black prince type found in eastern Himalayas. Apart from these 2 butterflies, a non-venomous snake, which is the Assam keelback, has also been rediscovered from the Geleng area of Arunachal Pradesh after a record of 129 years. So these 3 species which have been discovered from Arunachal Pradesh, so these are important. First is striped hairstreak, elusive prince. These 2 species are of butterflies, and one is a non-venomous snake, which is the Assam keelback. Now moving to the question part, a recently discovered striped hairstreak is a dash बटरफ्लाई, फिश, स्नेक और फ्रॉग. क्विकली कमेंट द करेक्ट आंसर. द करेक्ट आंसर विल बी ऑप्शन ए, दैट इज बटरफ्लाई. नाउ मूविंग टू द नेक्स्ट न्यूज. रिसर्चर्स फ्रॉम केरला एंड पुणे डिस्कवर्ड अ रेयर प्लांट स्पीशीज कॉल्ड ग्लोबा एंडरसोनी फ्रॉम द सिक्किम हिमालयस. And this species has been found near the Teesta River Valley region after a gap of about 136 years. So after a very, very long time, this species has been found. So this is important. And in 1875, the British botanist Sir George King collected it from Sikkim Himalayas. This plant is commonly known as dancing ladies or swan's flower. And its IUCN status is critically endangered. So this is a very important species as it is critically endangered. And the feature, the unique feature of this plant is that it usually grows on a rocky slope in the outskirts of evergreen forest in the form of a lithophyte. That is, the plants that grow on bare rock or stone, these are called lithophyte. So this plant, it grows on a rocky slope in the outskirts of evergreen forest in the form of lithophyte. And now moving to the question part. Where is a rare plant species named Globa andersoni discovered? Quickly comment the correct answer. Where is this plant species discovered? Sikkim, Kerala, Karnataka and Manipur. The correct answer will be option A, that is Sikkim. So friends, here we have comprehensively covered daily current affairs and related questions. I hope you like this session. Please like it, share it as much as you can. If you have any doubt, you can mention that in comment box. And please daily follow this daily current affairs session. Also ask your friends to join this session. It will be very helpful for you all. And keep preparing well. Keep following us. All the best. Thank you so much.